It begins with a view. A crib at 2 a.m., a teenage room with headphones on, a kitchen late-night snack. Nothing cinematic, no obvious crimes. Just ordinary intimacy. That ordinariness is what sold it on the black market. Victim dialogue spoken by a mother after she sees her baby monitor clip posted online.
I thought the camera loved us. I thought it was keeping him safe. I wasn't hacked by a stranger. I was betrayed by my own camera.
I watch. I map. I stage. The camera is a lens and a mirror. It shows me the room and reveals what the room tells me. Schedule, patterns, habits.
We put cameras in our homes to keep danger out. But a lens pointed outward can be twisted inward. A midnight whisper on a feed. A neighbor's laugh that's not a laugh. We put cameras in our homes to keep danger out, but a lens pointed outward can be twisted inward. A midnight whisper on a feed. A neighbor's laugh that's not a laugh. The watcher becomes the watched, and privacy cracks open like glass. You're tuned into Decoding Cybersecurity. I'm your chronicle keeper, Rakesh Nayam. And tonight we go inside a story that turned ordinary homes into open stages for strangers. This is the tale of hacked CCTV cameras and the people who learned the hard way what it means to be exposed. Chapter 1, The Silent Watcher, When Comfort Becomes Exposure. They were ordinary setups, a baby monitor above a crib, a porch camera at the front gate, a cheap dome over a small shop window. Families installed them to sleep easier, to see who's at the door, to watch pets while at work. 1,000 homes, 1,000 blinking red LEDs. A web of devices meant to protect. Instead, those same blinking lights became beacons.
I look for the open doors. I type a name, admin. I try a password. I don't crash a wall. I walk through the entrance nobody bothered to lock.
It begins with a view, a crib at 2 a.m., a teenage room with headphones on, a kitchen late night snack. Nothing cinematic, no obvious crimes, just ordinary intimacy. That ordinariness is what sold it on the black market. Chapter 2, The Open Door, Default Keys and Reckless Convenience. Most devices ship with convenience over security. Default usernames, simple passwords, remote access turned on out of the box. People install, they check the feed and they move on. No one thinks to change the little sticker credentials. No one thinks their camera will ever be more than a comfort.
I catalog devices with a sweep. I identify models. Default credentials work like old keys. I don't need finesse. I need laziness on the other side.
Default creds are only the start. Exposed streaming ports like RTSP, UPnP rules that auto-map internal devices to the internet, and cloud-configured P2P services that promise easy remote access often create invisible bridges. Together, they form an open network of private windows. Trivia challenge. Which of these everyday devices has been documented as hacked at scale, similar to CCTV cameras? A. Refrigerators. B. Smart TVs. C. Baby monitors. D. All of the above. We'll return to this. The answer ties into the bigger point. Stay sharp. The market of shadows when peaking becomes a product. Once feeds are available, they don't vanish. They're monetized. Catalogs appear. Group chats form where clips are labeled and traded. A buyer pays for access to someone's living room for a night. Another pays to monitor a neighborhood for patterns.
I tag feeds. Baby cam 02, front gate 44, night shift warehouse. Some buyers want to watch. Some buyers are looking for patterns when people leave, when lights go off, when packages are taken.
It's not all voyeurs. Burglars use feeds to scope houses. Scammers use glimpses to socially engineer victims. And some sellers are indiscriminate. They don't care whose footage it is, just how much they can sell it for. Chapter 3, The Human Cost, The Moment You Know You've Been Seen. This is where the plot stops being about data and starts being about people. Privacy violations turn intimate moments into nightmares. Victim dialogue spoken by a mother after she sees her baby monitor clip posted online.
I thought the camera loved us. I thought it was keeping him safe. I wasn't hacked by a stranger. I was betrayed by my own camera.
That quote nails the cruelty. The camera is a trusted object. Once that trust is broken, the damage runs deeper than stolen files. People feel violated, unsafe in their own homes, second-guessed in their most private choices. Chapter 4, The Technical Curtain, How the Hack Really Happens. Let's pull back the curtain a little, not to teach attack patterns, but to explain the conceptual mechanics so people understand risk. Reconnaissance. Attackers scan the internet for device signatures, model types, open ports, exposed services. Initial access, often via default credentials, misconfigured ports, or vulnerable vendor cloud APIs. Sometimes through credential stuffing, trying leaked username password pairs en masse. Persistence. Once inside, attackers enable remote services, install lightweight backdoors, or rely on always-on cloud channels that maintain access. Lateral mapping. Cameras sit on local networks. From the camera, attackers can probe other devices, info network layout, and if lucky, reach devices with more valuable access. Exfiltration. Footage is recorded, packaged, and pushed to remote servers, or shared directly in chat groups. Some actors also harvest personal data visible in frames, mail, IDs on desks, even credit cards left near counters. Monetization. Access is sold, rented, or used to facilitate other crimes.
I watch. I map. My stage. The camera is a lens and a mirror. It shows me the room and reveals what the room tells me. Schedule, patterns, habits.
The key takeaway, attackers seldom need 0 days to wreak havoc. They thrive on simple misconfigurations and human convenience. Chapter 5, The Twist, The Cloud That Promised Convenience. Just when you think the problem is only about lazy passwords, there's a twist.
I don't always need a default credential. Sometimes the device talks for me. Some cameras use cloud B2B with hard-coded vendor tokens. Once the token is found or a vendor's service is misconfigured, entire model ranges become reachable without any user-level mistake.
The twist. In several investigations, researchers found that vulnerability wasn't just user negligence. It was vendor convenience. Out-of-the-box remote access, weak cloud authentication, and hard-coded service tokens allowed attackers to enumerate and access cameras en masse. Owners who believed they were safe because they used official cloud were blindsided. This flips the narrative. Responsibility sits not only with the homeowner, but also with manufacturers and service providers who ship devices with brittle remote access assumptions. Chapter 6, The Exposure Spiral, When One Feed Becomes Many. From a single camera feed, attackers can glean addresses, identifiable items, shift patterns, all of which escalate the risk. A clip showing a visible wallet or a utility bill can be used for identity fraud. A camera overlooking a child's room can be weaponized for harassment.
I see a desk with a pay stub. I know the date. I correlate with social posts. Patterns form like a spider web. I pull a thread and the web trembles.
That's the exposure spiral. What seems harmless accumulates into real-world threat vectors. Chapter 7, The Hunt, Community, Researchers, and Law Enforcement Pushback. Not everyone stood by. Security researchers, community volunteers, and law enforcement mounted a response. They built detection tools, scanned for open services, and notified ISPs. They published lists and urged device recalls. Telegram marketplaces were disrupted, servers were taken down, but for every takedown, another server sprang up.
We moved fast. We mapped infrastructure. We issued takedown requests. But the market adapts. Actors shift channels, rebrand groups, and keep trading. It's a game of whack-a-mole across borders.
Some progress came in awareness. Consumers began changing passwords. Vendors patched firmware. But patching is a race. Many devices are abandoned by manufacturers soon after release, leaving long-term users exposed. The trivia reveal, the bigger IoT picture. Remember the trivia? Which devices beyond cameras have been hacked at scale? A. Refrigerators. B. Smart TVs. C. Baby monitors. D. All of the above. The correct answer is D. All of the above. From fridges used as spam relays to smart TVs that serve malicious content or expose audio, to baby monitors turned into listening devices. IoT is wide open when convenience outpaces security. The problem is systemic, not isolated. Chapter 8, The Human Aftermath, Fear Recovery and New Rules. Victims reported sleepless nights. Some unplugged every device and lived for months in a half-lit analog world. Others file police reports, but evidence trails are messy and cross-jurisdictional. Insurance companies began to ask pointed questions. Families relearned how to secure their digital homes. Chapter 9, Cyber Pro Breakdown, 7 Ways to Protect Your Home Cameras. You want action. Here's a practical conceptual checklist to harden home CCTV. Not a command list, but clear implementable steps. Change defaults and strengthen authentication. Replace factory usernames and passwords immediately. Use unique passphrases and consider a password manager for record keeping. Segment and isolate. Put cameras on a separate guest VLAN or IoT network so they cannot access sensitive devices like work laptops or NAS boxes. Limit remote exposure, disable universal plug and play, UPnP, and avoid exposing RTSP or other streaming ports directly to the internet. Use vendor cloud services only if they use strong modern authentication. Keep firmware updated. Regularly check for vendor updates. If a vendor stops patching a model, plan to replace it. Monitor outbound connections. Use router or network monitoring to detect unusual outbound traffic spikes from camera IPs. Alerts can be configured for anomalies. Harden physical and privacy controls. Cover lenses when not needed. Disable microphones if you don't use them. Position cameras to avoid capturing sensitive documents. Choose trustworthy vendors and audit cloud settings. Prefer vendors with transparent security practices, documented patch timelines, and strong encryption options. Audit cloud permissions and revoke third-party integrations you don't use.
These are practical, effective defenses. We can reduce risk dramatically with basic hygiene. The attackers exploit friction, anything that makes security inconvenient. Remove that friction.
Chapter 10, Closing Reveal, a Bittersweet Victory. There's a bitter small victory in this story. Some of the largest caches of leaked footage were traced back to models using a particular family of P2P cloud services with weak authentication defaults. Vendor patches and coordinated takedowns closed many doors. Parents regained quiet nights. But the underlying lesson stayed: convenience baked into products can become a liability for years. If this episode rattled you, good. Let it. Use that energy to act. change passwords, check firmware, and put your cameras on an isolated network. Share this story with someone who still uses default credentials. You've been watching Decoding Cybersecurity. I'm your chronicle keeper, Rakesh Nayam. Subscribe, join the playlist of real cyber incidents, and stay sharp, because protecting your home is now both physical and digital.